And now, the third point is to get to work. And the first thing you need is a sales funnel. With Builderall, you have affiliate links. But in affiliate marketing, the number one thing to do is not to send people to your affiliate link. This is the number one mistake that everyone does, every beginner. But don't do this mistake. Just send people to a lead capture, an email capture page. Because then you grow your list, and in 3 months, 6 months, you will have 1,000 or more people to write to if you want, because you want to send another product or to talk about this product, anything, you will have 1,000. If you send people to your affiliate link, you will have no one, and so it's not good for your future yourself. In the case of Builderall, it's a bit particular, once again, because when you send people to register for a free account on Builderall, you get their email, you can contact them. So it's like if you send them to your lead capture page. So it's a bit particular because in Builderall, yes, you can send directly to your affiliate link to open a free account, because the company doesn't keep for themselves like most of the other companies that do in affiliate marketing. They keep the customer for themselves. You don't know the email address. Here is not the same. You send them, they are your own leads. You have the email, you can contact them again. So you could use a simple affiliate link to the 7 days free trial of Builderall. But it's always better to create a lead capture page. Why? Because then you have control of this capture page. You can do what you want on it. It's not like the affiliate link. The control is on the seller, on Builderall. So if you create. So I want to show you how to start to work with the magic funnels. Magic funnel is just a form that you put on your page. And when people fill in a first name, email, then they submit. You get their email address, but also it opens them a free Builderall account. So it does the two things in one. And you open them and you can still keep them on your own pages. So it means you create a second page. I will show you. This is free magic funnels. It is about the work. I did this page. We are in the Builderall editor Pixel Perfect. This is the how to create websites. So it's a very good editor. For me, it's the best editor I've seen in over 20 years of internet and 30 years of computing. It's not like a Wix or all the others with grids. No, it's Pixel Perfect. You have total control. Very good. Anyway, it's not the... So I made this page. This is my lead capture page. But since Builderall is so particular, I don't need to do a simple video and form, put your email. I can be free, so I made three videos. I talk about Builderall, the plans. I have the buttons with my direct affiliate links, so they can buy it. I show them my offer, because this is very important, is to give an offer, to give people a reason to buy from you instead of buying directly from the company or buying from another affiliate. This is what I've learned in affiliate marketing, and what you can learn when you do the number one, when you get the knowledge about the top affiliate, what they have in common, you will see that having an offer is like everyone. So if they don't have, they are not in the top. So I made this page, I have a button for my offer, and I have also an affiliate link on the home page of Builderall. But then at the bottom, and I say it in the videos, in all the videos, I say, but if you want to try Builderall for free, you just fill in this form. First name, email, and a password. And you click, and it opens a new free Builderall trial account, and it redirects you to another page I made. So they stay on my website, and they say, welcome, you have opened your free Builderall account, now blah, 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 you can log in into your Builderall account, and it will send them to their account. But I said, at the bottom, I said, but if you pay today, if you buy it, then Builderall will give you a bonus that they don't give if you don't buy today. So they still can click, and then since they are already logged in because they just have created their account, they won't have to enter again first name, email. You know, they go straight to the payment checkout. So on the second page, they can still buy it now, you know, but they already have opened. If they don't buy it, they are my leads. So this is why, this is how to start the work, is to do a magic funnel like this. Because then you send traffic, you make a promotion of Builderall by sending them to this page, not to your affiliate link of Builderall. Because all your affiliate links, they are here already, and you control this. I made a menu, they can look more pages if they want, but you know, they are in my page. So I will show you how to do it. It's easy, let's say it's very easy. You have to, it's very easy when you know how to use Pixel Perfect, of course, because to make all this page, you know, to need to know how to use the editor. So it's like working, and you start to work. And you add a contact form here. I will show you what you need to put, you know, configure. Here in default, in edit, you need to post the information of this form to a specific email URL. So it's office.builderall.com/US if you want in English, /office/create /redir for redirection equals, and here you type in the URL of your next page, you know, the page where I say welcome, you have open, and if you take buy now, you get a bonus. This is the URL of this page. This means it will open the account and it will redirect to this. So now, I close it. There is something else to check, is the fields. Very important to have the good names. And here, you know, when they open an account, they are my leads. So how does Builderall know that they should attribute them to me? Is in elements, your first name, email, password, and hidden field. I have two hidden fields. The name should be cadastro_AID, and this is your affiliate ID, your number. It's for your second account. You know, if you set up as two accounts, for your second account, you put. So they will know that you are the affiliate who has created a new account for this person. So if they become a customer, you will get the commission. So cadastro_AID, and there is another one. Is this one, is a new one, is cadastro_origem. And here in the value, you put what you want. So I've put the URL of this page. It's just something that the value, you will see it in your leads list. So you will know where does this lead comes from. Because at some point, you will not have only one leads capture page. You will create many sources of new leads. So, you know, to have different value and to know where they come from, it allows you to analyze the data and see what source of leads are very performant, and then to increase your marketing effort on or your traffic generation to this lead capture page. So it's very important when you set it up to put the value, and it will be of use in 1 month, 2 months, 3 months when you will do the analysis of your leads list, where they come from. At this point, it will be very important. So that's why. And then the three other fields, first name, they all need to have a specific tag name. Cadastro_nome, NOME, because those are Brazilian developers, so they put in Portuguese. This is a bad choice, but that's the way it is. So cadastro_nome. For the name, cadastro_email for email, and this one is the cadastro_senna, SENHA for the password. If you don't put the password, it will generate a random one for, so, you know, you could not have a password here. The form will be simpler, but then when they log in to their account, it will be written, you have this default password, please change it. It makes another step. So it's better to, I think, to have it in the form, even if I don't like to have too many feeds. It's better to have it in the form, so they put their password that they like, and there will not, won't be an extra step later on. But one could just not put it, and it will be fine. Or you can put a default value, like a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and then on the next page, on this page, you say, okay, welcome, you have your account, your password is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and if you want to change it, you go to your profile, but you don't have to, just remember, it's this password. You can do that also. So, that's all. I think I said everything for this introduction, because it was meant to be a short introduction, and now it's been 40 minutes, so I don't know if you're still here. I will leave you. Thank you very much. Bye-bye.